What is eddy current and how you can use it for testing? This and more you will find out now. If we have a magnet and we move it through the air, nothing happens. We only move a magnetic field through the air. But if we move this magnet over an aluminium plate, we move the aluminium plate on without touching it. And this is already due to eddy currents. We induct eddy currents with our magnetic field. The eddy currents create a countermagnetic field, and this field works against our movement, and we move the plate. Well, let's take a look on two material examples. We have here titanium and aluminium. Let's try to move them. So we have our titanium and aluminium, and titanium is really hard to move. Not very easy. And that's because titanium has a very low electrical conductivity, and aluminium. Aluminium has a very high electrical conductivity, so we induct a lot of eddy current and we generate a lot of force. Let's take a closer look at the whole thing. We again take our magnet and move our magnetic field over the aluminium plate. According to the Faradaic induction law, we now induce eddy currents in the material. Due to Lenz's rule, the eddy currents generate a magnetic field which counteracts our transmitting field. The faster we move the magnetic field across the plate, the more eddy currents are induced and the larger our counter field becomes. Earlier we saw that in materials with a low electrical conductivity, such as titanium, less eddy currents are induced than in aluminium. Since a crack means a local change in electrical conductivity, less eddy currents are induced in the crack area. Now, in the application, we cannot move a magnet back and forth all the time. Therefore, an induction coil is used instead of a magnet. We then apply an alternating current to the coil and thus generate an alternating magnetic field, that is a moving magnetic field. In some applications, the alternating magnetic field changes the direction up to 10 million times per second. Since we can no longer use our hand as a force sensor, we now somehow have to record a measuring signal. For this, we use an additional measuring coil, and the measuring coil records the resulting magnetic field, meaning the difference between the transmitted field and the magnetic field of the eddy currents. Now we have to get the signal on the screen somehow. Here we see our alternating magnetic field and at the lower left corner the corresponding signals, the transmitting signal and the receiving signal. From these two signals, the phase shift or the time delay from the transmitter to the receiver and the amplitude or the signal height can now be calculated. These are displayed in the so-called impedance plane. Let's take a look on the whole thing in reality. We move the probe on our plate and we direct see a signal from our aluminium without moving the probe. Yeah. Sure, we are using the alternating magnetic field generated direct in the probe. If we move on Titan, we are close to the edge of the impedance plane, so we have a totally different signal compared to aluminium. Moving on the other aluminium standard, we have three cracks inside, and if we move over a crack, we clearly see a signal of this crack. Sure, the signal is much lower compared to the difference aluminium and titanium, but we can evaluate it really clear. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed our video, subscribe our channel and see you next time.